I'm going to be apologizing for making a mistake, for saying that if we don't pay tithe, you might not make it to heaven. I'm sorry, that's wrong. That's not in the Bible.
I want you to hold up for a minute before you continue listening to Mr. Adeboye's confession, because this is a public confession and we should commend him for admitting that he has been lying, to admitting that he has been wrong and he has been manipulating masses for financial gains. The gravitas of what he has just said might be misconstrued should we not make the context of his confession accessible to the level of a layman's understanding. What Mr. Adeboye is merely saying is, everything I have told you about tithing has been a lie, and it was motivated by my intention to milk you, to take every piece of your salary, of your income, to enrich myself, using the scripture, using Christ, using heaven as a proxy. He's saying that I instilled fear in your subconscious so that you feel obligated to part with every 10% of your income with my ministry. Because in his previous sayings, he said, if you do not pay tithe, you will never go to heaven. Forget it. With conviction. And he did not say it once. He said it several times. And we are talking about 15 years operating with this particular principle. And at his age, he has accumulated wealth that if Adeboye resigns today, his children, his entire generation will never smell poverty. And he has done so by lying. That's what has happened over the years. It can be sugarcoated as a mistake, but what it has been was a big, big lie. And it was all at the expense of your salvation. So the question is, to the followers, we have been saying, no, Papa is right. Papa explained what he meant. Now he has come out to say he was wrong. Now he has come out to say he has been lying about tithe. Where do you stand now? What do you have to say? This is just a question, because this statement alone is a blanket statement. It says a lot about tithing. That everything he has said about tithing and not going to heaven was a lie. And it has been a lie. And we have been saying that it was a lie. But you're insulting us. Now we have reached a point whereby the one who said it admits that he was lying. He was conning you. Because that's what was happening. But religion is protected by constitution. They say you're doing it voluntarily. You're giving voluntarily. No one is putting a firearm on your head to give. But when they tell you that you're not going to go to heaven if you don't pay it, that's like blackmail. There's no volunteering there. There's no willful giving there. Because if you're a believer, if you're a Christian, you do everything that you do so that you go to heaven. And then if someone says, if you don't do this particular thing, you will not go to heaven. What does that mean? It's exploiting you. But still, let's give him his flowers for admitting that he was wrong. It's not easy to admit that he was wrong. Now we leave it to Pastor Oyedepo as well, Bishop Oyedepo, to come out and admit that he has been wrong as well about these money subjects. And all the likes of Ibiome, they must also come now and follow suit, because their grant, the DGO, has said it. Your poor enanches must now also come and admit that they have been conning people, conning masses, and using Malachi as a proxy, using heaven as a proxy. It's very sad, and I want you to listen. I want you to listen now to the last part, which disappointed me a bit, but we are here to analyze it, you and me. Check it out.
What the Bible says is, he had peace with all men, and holiness, without which no man shall see God. Now, let me tell you. Listen to me. You know, it is possible to be right and wrong at the same time. I prove it to you. I mean, I'm a scientist, so I know that. For years, we thought that light travels in straight lines. Now, is that correct? At least those of you who know a little bit of physics will say, sure, but light doesn't bend at corners, it goes straight. But later on, we discover it's not just what, not straight as a rod. Light travels in waves, going one direction, but in waves. It is wrong to limit you to 10%. At a time when some of you should be 20%, 30%, 40%, 10% should be for beginners. Giving should be violently. Violently.
Okay, so now should we rule out the apology? Because what nonsense is this now? First, you say that I was wrong. I made a mistake. I lied about tithing and going to heaven. And then along the way, you now go back to your roots and say someone can be right and wrong at the same time in science, in physics, in chemistry. Someone can be wrong and right at the same time. Let me correct you, my senior. Let me call you my senior. I'm only calling you my senior because I'm actually happy that you owned up that you were wrong at first. But let me correct you. Being a scientist or scientific theories or how you interpret chemical reactions or how you interpret physical behavior is totally different from how you interpret scripture, totally different from how you teach the gospel. In scripture, there are no two ways about it. You cannot be right and wrong at the same time. Are you listening, my senior? You cannot be dual. It's either you are right or you are wrong. So don't maintain the lie. You had started very well that you were wrong, you made a mistake. What was difficult with you holding on to that admission that you were wrong? Why now try to be smart about it and try to infuse your scientific understanding of how one may be wrong and how one may be right and try to connect it with scripture? With scripture, my brother, listen, it's either you're right or you are wrong. You were wrong. There's no way you were either right or wrong, white or black. And you even went on to say you were wrong because I was limiting you to 10%. Come on, Mr. Adeboye. Come on. Do you really need their money that much that you are willing to swallow your own vomit? You just vomited your wrongness and admitted that you were wrong. And a few seconds down the line, it rang a bell again in your conscience that no, you still need the money. Correct it. I was limiting you to 10% when some of you must be paying 20%, 30%, 40%, 50%, or even 90% of your salary. That's what now you are implying. That one can be wrong and right. So you were wrong because you were saying they should only pay 10%. And you are right now that you are now removing the 10% and there's no more cap to tithing. They should now pay 20%. 30, 40, 50. My people. So which is which now? Help me understand this man. Help me understand this man. Because I'm totally confused, as you are. First he says he was wrong. He made a mistake. A few seconds down the line, he said, no, I was wrong because I was limiting you to 10%. Which means someone might be right and wrong at the same time. This is not science. This is scripture, my brother. So should people pay 20, 30, 40, 50? Is you are alleging. So which means you are not wrong to start off with. Do you see how they play with your minds? He still needs your money. He still wants your money. He still wants you to keep on contributing a percentage of your income. But what does he want to do with the money? Because this is no longer about him. What is he building? Where is he taking all this money? Who is he giving all this money to? Mr. Adeboye, at your age, you should slow down, my brother. You should be retiring right now. You should be giving leadership to your establishment, to someone, to take it over. But you still want the money. For what exactly? All this is vanity. And you talk of heaven, that there are houses of gold in heaven, but you want to build more houses of gold here on earth, if there were truly houses of gold in heaven, if you truly believed it, would you be investing so much on this earth? Would you be accumulating all this wealth for yourself on this earth? My people, let me not go too deeper, but tell me what you think now that he said he made a mistake. And then he said, no, the mistake that he made was he had put a cap on the amount you should pay. One can pay 20, 30, 40, 50. And him saying that one can be right and wrong at the same time, which means he's not entirely admitting that he was wrong, but he's saying he was 50% wrong and he was 50% right. He was 50% wrong that he said, if you don't tithe, you will not go to heaven. But he was 50% right by saying that money should still come, but he mustn't put a cap on how much should come as tithe. these old men defeat me, honestly. But tell me what you think in the comments. And to the followers, please try to be reasonable. I don't have a problem with people who disagree, but do it so, you know, in an intellectual manner. Be smart about your submissions. Don't just be ranting here and cursing me that, oh, this will happen to you. Your end is coming. Listen, my end is nowhere near coming. I'm here to stay. This message has put your spiritual father in a corner of admitting that he was wrong. So there's nothing you can curse me and will happen to me. I'm highly guarded and protected by the Almighty. One who works for me or with me or in me is mightier than the ones that work in your spiritual fathers. Get it through your head that I was called for this. Tell me what you think in the comments, my people. And don't forget to leave a like. I'm out.